The DA has just released a statement on its long-running battle with Cape Town Mayor Patricia De Lille. To tell us more, we're joined via Skype by the party's Deputy Federal Chair, Natasha Mazzone. Natasha, thank you so much for joining us this Saturday afternoon. Now, we were told ahead of this gathering that a decision into the future of Patricia De Lille was supposed to have been made at this meeting, if I'm correct. What's the latest? What went wrong?
Nothing's gone wrong. The Democratic Alliance started its deliberations into the question around Mayor De Lille and her submissions made to the Federal Council. In the interim, what happened was Mayor De Lille served the Democratic Alliance with new legal papers. The deliberations were then suspended because the Democratic Alliance now needs to take legal advice. And early next week, we will resume as FedEx to continue the deliberations once we have our legal advice.
Now, Patricia De Lille, this has been going on for some time now. Patricia De Lille has repeatedly said that she wanted a transparent process to take place with regards to allegations against her, and indeed also for her to be able to clear her name, as she has put it. Has the DA been able to provide that evidence for this process to take place, as Patricia De Lille herself has requested? What's the latest on that front?
Well, there's two processes that are taking place at the moment. The one is the disciplinary hearing, and the other one is the consideration of the motion of no confidence. And the two issues are completely separate. So FedEx this weekend was discussing and deliberating the motion of no confidence that was brought about with over 70% of the councillors of the DA in the Cape Town caucus. So everything is transparent, everything is open and clear. The Democratic Alliance is taking this matter incredibly seriously. We are treating it with the necessary seriousness, of course, and that is one of the reasons that we stopped deliberations, that we can consult with our legal teams to make sure that going ahead everything is 100% procedurally correct.
Now, if that is the case and court procedures do go ahead, what happens next? Will the DA then be in a position to, pardon the word, get rid of Patricia De Lille as it apparently wants to?
Look, I think the fact that the FedEx has taken such a drastic step as to stop deliberations and to resume them early next week goes to show how seriously the party is dealing with this matter. I think it would be premature of me to say what the outcomes of these deliberations are going to be. I think it's premature of anyone to assume what the outcomes of these deliberations will be. I think we'll be in a much better position to comment once the FedEx has met early next week and once we have taken legal advice on these brand new legal papers that were served on the DA this very morning.
Will you admit that this ongoing saga obviously has caused a lot of frustration on both sides as well as within your party? Will you admit, though, that the longer it goes on for, the more potential reputational damage is being done to your party, indeed with the elections of 2019 looming large?
Marcel, undoubtedly, there's a huge amount of reputational damage that is done. We are the first ones to admit it. The brand damage is massive to us. But we are the party of accountability and we are the party of clean governance. So it would be very remiss of us not to take any allegations of mismanagement or misconduct very, very seriously. So we risk the reputational damage to make sure that we always provide an absolutely clean and fair and clear government to those people who vote for us. But yes, look, we want this matter sorted out as quickly as possible too, but we are absolutely determined to make sure that procedure is always followed and that at all times the matter is handled with the seriousness and with the necessary attention it deserves.
We'll leave it there for now. The DA's Deputy Federal Chair, Natasha Mazzone, joining us via Skype.